Parliament on the Human Rights Committee are concerned at what they say is the increasing number of foreign inmates in jails across the country, with some saying this could be a source of a diplomatic spat with a neighboring country. This came after the Uganda National Medical Alliance on Prisoner Support released a report indicating as many as 4,660 inmates are languishing in jails. But the Uganda Prison Services has denounced the findings and flatly rejected the report.
In their report to the Parliamentary Committee on Human Rights, the Uganda National Medical Alliance for Prisoners Support reported that Uganda is stuck with 4,660 foreign inmates in its prisons, which alarmed members of parliament. MPs are concerned that the issue might lead to a diplomatic feud between Uganda and her neighbors.
The number is high. Now you find in Mbarara only, in Mbarara region, they are having 669. Greater Masaka, they are having 491. Greater Chiges, they are having 502. And the Central Region, they are having 2,239. While Northern, they are having 759.
If this is also known internationally, it can be a serious case for Uganda. If we can have such foreigners in, look at Imbara region. As if even when you add all the other types let me see, Central Region, even when you add up the 429 92 5, they cannot even make half of the number of foreigners who are in the prisons in the Central Region.
The report indicates that majority of foreign prisoners are Congolese and mostly refugees who are arrested on cases of illegal entry.
It's quite alarming because we here in Uganda, we have also our fellow foreigners detained in relevant countries like Qatar, China. So by doing so, we try also to make exchange program for supporting our fellow Ugandans detained in foreign countries. So it's not really good for foreigners to be detained, because the same way we treat these people here is the same way they are treating our fellow Ugandans in different countries like China, Qatar.
The Committee on Human Rights has also learnt about the increased cases of child mortality rates in prisons due to poor antenatal and reproductive care given to pregnant and lactating inmates.
Lack of nutrition support for detained lactating mothers, pregnant women, children detained with their parents and newborn babies in prison. Then there's also this one, child mortality and morbidity. People give birth and children die while in detention facilities. Madam Chair, that is a core issue which needs to be real. I don't know about how best you can handle it, but it is happening in Chibwe, it has happened.
This research, which was conducted in prisons in Greater Masaka, southwestern Uganda, Central and Northern Region, has also established the increased number of inmates who have spent over 2 years on remand. The number stands at 1,348.
Here, we wanted to engage in exchange, prisons exchange, so that we can also aim on how we can support our fellow Ugandans detained in foreign countries. So the table below here shows a number of different characters, like number of inmates remanded over 2 years, there are people who are in prisons, they don't go in court. Number of inmates detained over land matters, the number is here.
However, the spokesperson of the Uganda Prison Services, Frank Baine, has dismissed the report findings, saying the organization has never been to any prison in Uganda.
This report you are bringing to me from so-called, is it Alliance for Prisoners Support something? First of all, I am not in the know of this organization. But fortunately, this report was not for prisons. This is a report to Parliament. And Parliament, I know the way it works. If there are issues that we need to explain, they will ask the Commissioner General to explain the allegations in this report. So for now, that's what I can comment.
Have you ever seen them in prison?
No, I have not seen them.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.